What is good, guys? We are here with Finch versus Wellyu for Snake Draft, and we can already see this is probably a Solvice Majorna. The Scarf Lady is going to be Healing Wish. Wellyu, you turn turn one on the land with a Scarf Grin. He can go into his Venusaur or into his Mew here. But yeah, this is most likely going to be a Solvice Majorna. Looking at Finch's team, not sure. I think his Grin is Ash. Coco is Z-Move. His lander should be Defensive Rocks because he has no Zygarde answers otherwise. And his Lottie should be Scarf, I already said that. And Pinsir looking really scary if he can weaken the Zapdos, or if he has Stone Age for Zapdos, that would be even better. But yeah, Vino or Mew, like I said, are coming out here. And since this is AV, he can just get a slow Volt Switch here. And HP Fire is not gonna do much, it's gonna do laughable damage. So he can Volt Switch into his Pinsir here. If he has Stone Age for his Zapdos. If he doesn't have that, he can just Volt Switch into something like Lottie. Like, looking at Finch's team, if his Pinsir doesn't have Stone Age, he's gonna have a lot of trouble like breaking Wellyu's team. So we will see. So that's the HP Fire, only the 50, nice chip, yeah. So here's the Pinsir, and if he's packing Stone Age, he can go for like SD and then blow the Zapdos away. I see you being the chat, bitch takes 45 from Magma Storm, maybe Mac. So there is the SD, I think you only set up if you have something to hit the Zapdos. So we'll see if he pulls out the Stone Age now, because otherwise I don't know why he would ever set up. If he didn't have a move to hit the Zapdos, he should have just doubled again to like Lottie to try and scare us out with a potential trick. So someone in chat said revealed Stone Age here, this guy, and they're all saying Ben. And he got muted for 7 minutes. Wait, what did Pearl just say? Set what? I think he has a typo there. Set what? This is too funny. Set speculation typo. Oh, correct. Yeah, okay. But yeah, just the way Finch played, this makes a lot of sense for this to be Stone Age. I'm not actually sure if Ricardo is on his team, but I know Ricardo is a big fan of Stone Age Pinsir. So if he's on his team and he gave him, I don't know if Ricardo gave him this. Finch might tell me if he sees this video. I will check out the snake teams after. I will look a bit more into that. And he has Stone Age and he pops the Zapdos, he does connect. I will have to get into snake a lot more. But at the moment my focus is on ult. So he's gonna go for U-turn here. The Majorna is just pretty free for Finch, and the Pinsir gets a kill next time when it comes in on the Venusaur. It kinda gets a kill. So there's no point for Finch to like staying in. Like, there's no point in staying in. So Wellyu knows that, and U turns out, gets the lander in. And Majorna is really important, especially it checks the opposing Majorna, he stays in. That was a really risky play, it worked out, but I myself wouldn't have made that play. He stays in twice, and oh god, Finch is on fire, you could say, but I would have not risked my Majorna there, because it's it's just so amazing, switches into the opposing Grand multiple times, and if this is opponent Majorna, if it's Calm Mind, this one checks it. And we will see if this is the ABR special Iron Head Majorna. There's the Shifky, he just Volt Switches out, okay. Because AV Majorna, the ABR set, sometimes from the Iron Head to it's to beat Calm Mind Clefable and opposing Calm Mind Majorna. Like, some of you might think that set is bad, but I like that set. Like, it shows how stupid Majorna is. Like, one of its best check is AV Majorna and with Iron Head, so do you still do damage when it Calm Minds up? It's kind of funny. So this Coco, he can threaten this actually no, Coco does not speed. Yeah, but Coco lives any one hit. Yeah, Coco does not speed, but Coco lives any one hit, so you can threaten this with a Gigavolt Havoc. He just goes for T-Bolt, and I think he's gonna go for U-turn or Volt Switch, one of the two. Whatever he has, whichever. U-turn is obviously better, because in the snake draft, in this phase, Ductrio is still allowed, so you still have to run a U-turn on Coco. And He can just go for defog here, since Relius Rocksetter is already dead. He gets rid of the rocks for his Pinsir, and Pinsir can put in work later. So now he's gonna go back to his own Midjourner or to his Coco, as those two are the best. Like, that's his only way, like, to stop this Midjourner from just running through his team. But I can't believe that he risked his own Midjourner earlier on the land or twice. But it worked out for him. He looks like a complete boss. But yeah, I don't know if I mentioned it yet, but NGNP is playing later versus Partial. So I'm gonna cover that live if I see it. I hope I'll be free. So now he goes in the Midjourner, and we would think he would go for a slow voltage, but he reveals the Iron Head. And it does 28, and that does enough damage. Like, it's only like a 5-hit KO or something like that with lefties. But this is an AV Midjourner, so the opposing Midjourner cannot really do damage to it. We saw earlier HP 5 from Venusaur did 15 if I recall correctly, so it did nothing. So like, this is just Bolt Beam Midjourner from Rally's side probably, and it's not gonna be able to do much to this. I can't wait for this Midjourner to attack, and it's gonna do pitiful damage, and the chat is gonna go wild. Just watch. Finch trying to make his opponent never use Broken Mons versus him again. But this is specific Midjourner set to stop opposing Midjourner. Yeah, Chansey is also one of the best mag checks. Unless you face that meme set, Shift Gear, Z Brick Break. But yeah, let's not talk about that set now. That's no set. That's something I would use in a meme video. No, yeah, Finch is obviously gonna spam Iron Head here. And when he gets, if he gets rid of this Midjourner, his Pinsir kind of wins the game, because whenever it comes on, Vino gets a kill, like I said earlier, and he's not gonna, he obviously can't kill the Mew or the Pinsir, or the Greninja, I meant the Mew or the Greninja, so he's gonna be switching out versus those, but he still has checks for those in the back. So like, Finch can't really lose this now, but like earlier, if he lost his Midjourner to the Lando, then he might have been in a bad spot, because this Midjourner would have just potentially just swept him. And there's a T-Bolt, and that's 18%. You see this? That is nothing. Every assault that should be Iron Head now. If Flash is useless. So now Relius realizes he can't really do anything, he's gonna switch. And he threatens this with a Will-O-Wisp, so I assume... if this Greninja especially could go into Gren on the Will-O-Wisp here. I assume it's a special Greninja. Otherwise he could just go into Coco, he already revealed that his Coco is special. He could go Coco or Lati here, like he, one of those three here, like he has a lot of options. I would probably go into the Coco or the Gren, as that's like a more offensive approach, because if you go into Lati, then you kind of have to double on the mag again. But yeah, well, he reads that really nice and doubles into his Venusaur. I assume we're gonna see a Leech Seed come out, maybe a Sludge Bomb. He does go for a Sludge Bomb, because he was trying to catch the Pinsir on a switch, but Finch should never go hard into Pinsir. I completely agree with not going hard into Pinsir. So he knows that Volio is most likely going to defog here, so he could go for U-turn here. It's a bit risky, but I think it's fine. If he doesn't want to risk that, he can just go hard into either Coco or Gren again, as he just should go hard into Gren on the Ice Beam. So that was well done. I thought that he would defog there, but Finch knew that he might go for Ice Beam, goes hard, Gren gets him there. Dark Pulse crit sucks a bit, because this Gren only has one more rock switch in now. But I don't think it mattered too much. So he predicts a U-turn and goes into Landorus. If he's is he Rocky Helmet? Is that revealed yet? He's not, okay. That would have been a fire play if the Greninja died to Helmet there. I think it was not revealed if he was Helmet. So he goes hard on the Coco, there's a defog, and I assume he's gonna go for like either U-turn predicted Vino or for a Gigavolt Havoc. Velio doesn't have any ground types left, but if Velio goes in the Vino here on U-turn, Pinsir gets a kill, so it's kind of a tough position for him. I can see Velio staying in predicting the U-turn. He stays in on a T-Bolt, goes for just Ice Beam. Yeah, I think he tried to predict the U-turn into the pincer, something like that. But yeah, now he's gonna be forced to softball up. Never mind, he does to the next T-Bolt. What am I saying? Is that Specs? No, I think he changed that moves earlier. I think that's just fast Mew with like maybe not max HP, maybe a bit more on Fizz Dev instead. But yeah, he gets the Venusaur low, which means the Venusaur is forced to heal and Pinsir gets a kill now. He can just click Frustration here. Frustration into Earthquake would kill the Majorna, so Majorna is not a switch in. Whatchamacallit. Yeah, for a second I thought that was Specs Goku because I did so much to the Mew. But that must be just a really fast Mew with not that much bulk. Like no speed def at all for sure. And maybe not even max HP. Like I said already. So yeah, this is a free Frustration and this game was just too funny earlier. The smoke just jet and well, the guy got like muted for 7 minutes and then Pearl's type was too funny too. Yeah, we shall see if Finch tries to build it after 6-0 of well, you can at least kill 1-1 because this game should be over. Majorna can still win if it well, use Majorna can still win if it freezes the opposing mag, maybe. So he sacks off the Gren. He's gonna go in the Mew slash. Oh, you know, the Mew was weakened, right? I think the Mew was weakened. So yeah, Majorna was the only player, but doesn't this just die to Earthquake? This should just die to Earthquake. Am I missing something here? Maybe Finch doesn't want to risk this Majorna having HP investment, but he should probably know if the Majorna has max special attack, or sometimes Majorna runs some HP instead of max special attack. But he should be able to tell from the damage that the opposing Majorna did to his own Majorna earlier. Maybe Earthquake is a war and he doesn't want to risk that, or he just doesn't want to risk the Majorna being HP invested, like I said. So T-Bolt is pretty free here. Yeah, he doesn't lose anything from T-Bolting. There is the Venusaur and there's a Para. So you can just U-turn here and Pinsir eats a Sludge Bomb, but I don't know if he wants to risk getting poisoned, but well, he just goes for Synth. Like, he was kind of forced to Synth, but I think he should have tried to go for Sludge Bomb and then like hope for crit poison on the Pinsir. Even though I don't think that matters, its only way of winning is if he freezes some of Finch's mons with his Majorna. I think that was his only way of winning at this point. But yeah, Pinsir clicks Frustration again and gets another kill here. Fun times, dude. Pinsir is just so great some matchups. I really think we're gonna see some Pinsir zone soon in some tournament games because Ducktrio got banned. That could definitely be something we might see. So yeah, now Finch is gonna switch again. He doesn't want to risk this. Like earlier he switched as well. Now he's got another round of lefty, so why would he stay in now? I think he's gonna try to preserve the 6-0. So he can go on his old Majorna here as that easily eats up every hit. I can see while you're going for T-Bolt, it's electric turn boosted. But at this point, like he has to hope for T-Bolt parrying Finch's mag or freezing it, like I said. And then setting up on that. So there's the mag. There is the shift gear. And if he gets the freeze now, that's his win con, he just goes for T-Bolt and does 12%. This is just too funny, like, AV Mac is so fat, so now he's going for the freeze and he does not get it. One last chance to get the freeze. Because if he gets the freeze, then he can calm it up and he could put in work. But I think he would have also been in range from Water Shuriken at that point. So yeah, this was really just a fun game, so I had to re-narrate this. I have like two more of these games that I have want to re-narrate. One was, Psychic Mewtwo versus, I forgot. But it was a really fun game as well, so stay tuned for that. It was like a cool game to watch. And the other one that I have is, I think Seijumas versus... dude, I forgot. I recorded so many games, I forgot all like some of them. Which exact player's game I recorded. But yeah, this was a fun one. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll be back later with hopefully Snake Game Live. Like, this is live as well, but one that is live narrated. I narrated over this one. There's gonna be one that is not over narrated. This is gonna be live. So stay tuned for that. Peace out.